You could teach and train professional level cybersecurity skills whenever you wanted to through gaming. Yes, video games. Sounds fun, right? And what if at the same time you could empower and educate students with realistic exposure to cyber scenarios? And what if you were equipped with the right tools and techniques to teach cybersecurity so it was more within reach? Well, it's easier than you think. In fact, we've worked with cybersecurity instructors worldwide to help them teach these skills to thousands of students. And those students have become professionals through the unique combination of realistic cyber scenarios and gaming. Now you might be thinking, wait, realistic, serious scenarios together with gaming? You betcha. And in this video, I'm gonna show you why it works and how it's done. Now, traditionally, cybersecurity is taught with textbooks, lectures, and homegrown cyber ranges. But what if that's not the way that your brain learns hands-on skills the best? What if you don't learn coding by deliberately studying it? But what if, instead, your brain can learn these skills naturally through playing? That's nuts, right? But it's true. Everyone has played games for fun, and bringing those kinds of activities into an academic setting bridges a gap that typically separates games from learning. But why is that a gap that we would want to bridge? Well, because gaming is gaining some serious ground in the classroom as a highly valued educational tool, and for good reasons. Video games are designed to keep players engaged. They encourage persistence, they keep students on task longer, they suppress a fear of failure, and they explore all kinds of styles of learning, from independent self-direction to collaboration with peers. Universities, boot camps, and training courses around the world are using gamification to make learning more effective. Did you know that when you learn through gaming, you can measure it in the brain? Gaming activates parts of your brain that aren't really colorful when you're learning in a traditional fact-based way. Areas like the left temporal cortex, the frontal and parietal cortices, and even the auditory cortex. These are the parts of our brain that are used for things like processing language, association of ideas, memory, and attention. Basically, when you learn through gaming, you're mixing two things: rational information and experience. And what this does is form neural connections, which when repeated, get stronger, and they result in long-term memory. Duolingo's founder and CEO, Luis von Ahn, cites the app's ability to let players compete with friends, work to maintain learning streaks, and gain experience points to learn without feeling like they're studying as one of the core reasons behind the success of that language learning gaming app. The point is, gamified education is a powerful combination of memory, emotion, and comprehension. And it's pretty different than just learning facts, which we forget way too easily. So that's the science behind gamification. But what makes gamification such a great way to help teach and learn cybersecurity? While learning cybersecurity isn't just about memorizing code sequences or finding your way around forensics tools like autopsy, it's about the ability to apply those skills critically, to be able to take that knowledge into the workplace. In other words, you have to be able to use those skills in real situations in your job. And gamification in the classroom, well, that can help in a couple important ways. First, it stacks on your existing knowledge. What you've learned so far is going to be important to get to where you need to go and what you need to learn next. It gives you something to hold on to and to refer to when you're learning those new nuts and bolts of the new material. Gaming also lets you play again. If you need reinforcement, if you forget a skill, or if you just need more practice, you can just start a new game and perform that skill over and over until you're comfortable. And that means you're only moving on when you feel, and you've proven, you're ready. And finally, gamification puts skills in context. It's not just click this button in a cyber range, it's a story. There's a reason behind what you're doing and what you're trying to accomplish, which means not only will you learn those skills more easily, you'll also know how and when to use them in the real world. And there's a lot more too. Gamification keeps students interested, so they're more motivated to stay in the game and also to come back to it. Gamification also gets you emotionally involved. You're competing against yourself. You're competing with your peers. You're working together to bring down the bad guys. And that emotional tie helps make the learning a more authentic part of your education. So gamification lets you focus on knowledge, reinforcement, and context to give you a deep, solid understanding of your cybersecurity education. So, okay, enough about the theory. How do you actually use gamification to teach and train? Well, after 20 years of development, research, and teaching, we've codified our knowledge into a platform called Project Ares. Project Ares is a game-inspired cybersecurity learning platform backed by a comprehensive catalog of cyber scenarios, each of which are designed to train specific cybersecurity tasks, knowledge, and skills. And the best part? These scenarios are realistic, like really real, meaning what students experience in these scenarios is representative of what they'll deal with on the job. We've taken the seriousness of cybersecurity skill development and wrapped gamification around it to make it both valuable and fun. Now, there are three different kinds of scenarios in Project Ares. First, the foundational battle room scenarios are skill-based, hands-on practice labs for individual learners. Now, these allow students to use authentic virtual machines with simple networks to complete tasks with or without the help of guided hints to practice basic cybersecurity skills. The specialized mission scenarios include multifaceted red or blue labs for individual learners or team-based collaboration. These are played in the context of a real-world threat scenario, and they encourage students to solve more complex problems where they'll face threats like botnets, phishing and exfiltration, ransomware, and much more. And finally, the assessments are capture the flag style scenarios that are designed for individuals to challenge and test their skills without any hints, using virtual machines to accomplish tasks and find flags. Now, for all of these scenarios, instructors have the ability to monitor student progression through the labs with session playback and reporting. They can also coach students in real time in the cyber range and assess the skills for grading by disabling hints and the in-game advisor, Athena. And on top of all of that, we also have a comprehensive media library, as well as a series of arcade-style cyber learning games to reinforce basic skills and knowledge. And of course, instructors are also equipped with a solution guide to every task in the scenario in the instructor-only area, and multiple teaching and implementation services are available from the team to help you get started using gamification in your classroom or training program. Now, we know that this is probably a bit different than what you might be used to, so I've got some resources for you to help you out. First of all, if you want to try out the gamification method in your own cybersecurity classroom, you can head down to the description below, or go to this link here to give it a try. Secondly, if you want a bit more help with Project Ares, or you're interested in seeing more about how exactly you could use it, you might like to look at our services. Now, they aren't free, they are paid services, but they are your complete step-by-step process to incorporating Project Ares in your teaching plans, including all the material that you'll need in one place, so all you have to do is just settle in and enjoy teaching or learning. Until next time, we'll see you on the training ground.